Hello, everybody. My name is Svetlana, and today we are talking about Marxism-Leninism, as well as the dictatorship of the proletariat, the state, and the party vanguard. First, let's start off with the dictatorship of the proletariat. Now, what exactly is the dictatorship of the proletariat, you might ask? Well, I'm going to have to talk about the tool that is the state. What exactly is the state, then? Vladimir Lenin described it as this: the state is an organ of class domination, an organ of oppression of one class by another. In other words, the state is used to repress and control the other class, usually by force. You can see this in every single current world government. One class, the bourgeois, is suppressing the other class, the proletariat. If the proletariat is to get into power via violent revolution, they are forced to suppress the bourgeois class using the state. But why is a violent suppression necessary? Well, as you probably know, the goal of Marxism-Leninism is communism. But communism is not instant. There are stages of communism. Socialism is the lower form of communism, and the classless, stateless, and moneyless utopian society that Karl Marx described is the higher stage of communism. Under socialism, the state is bound to instantly start to wither away after the revolution is successful, and the revolution being successful is the complete destruction of the old capitalist order. The state must be used to heal the wounds of the revolution and crush the parasites that are the capitalists. After that point, communism can slowly be achieved. Anarchists say about themselves being anti-authoritarian and calling the proletariat state an opportunistic and state capitalist dictatorship. However, they have utopian and idealistic demands of the state being destroyed within 24 hours. The state must be used as a tool. If the state is to not exist in the early stages of socialism, what is to prevent the capitalists from seizing back power? Capitalist powers try to destroy the Soviet Union in two absolutely destructive wars, that being the Intervention War and the Great Patriotic War. In many ways, the powerful state that is the USSR had saved them. The importance is to make sure that the state is against the bourgeois and for the people. Thus, we can now understand the term dictatorship of the proletariat. Marx, Engels, and Lenin helped formulate this word. Why is it a dictatorship? It is a dictatorship as there is no real freedom under the state. And as long as a state exists, there will be no freedom. And when there is freedom, there will be no state. A common complaint about dictatorships of the proletariat and Marxist-Leninist nations is that freedom is fantasy, freedom is a myth. Well, the exact same thing can be said about capitalist nations. No matter how much of a democracy they are all the same. Every democracy that has existed was just like the ancient Greek democracy, that being a democracy for the white Greek slavers. A nation without elections has an oppressor for their entire lifetime, while in a nation with liberal elections, such as the United States, the oppressed class pick one out of two people to rule and repress them. No politician in a Western nation has ever supported the people and the proletariat. Every capitalist nation, no matter how republican or monarchist it is a dictatorship too. Yes, even social democratic countries that you might wish to think are for the people are also serving for the interests of the bourgeois class. In conclusion, a true democratic country has never existed and won't as long as a state exists. A common misconception is Marxists absolutely adore the state. This is false. Marxists do not love the state or wish for the state to exist forever. The idea that stateless society is possible instantaneously is a utopian idea. Marxism realizes this and knows that the machinery of the state must be used as a tool for the proletariat and against the bourgeois class in order to slowly achieve communism. This arises the question of how the proletariat can get into power. The most common idea is a revolutionary vanguard. A vanguard is like an intellectual party which can be used to seize power and then educate the masses of the words of Marx. After this point, the vanguard will be deemed unnecessary. The vanguard was seen in many revolutions, such as the Russian October Revolution, and is many times noted as relatively successful. The idea of the vanguard appeared as the conditions of 1917 Russia. Russia was practically a feudal society in this era, with there being barely any industrialized factories, and there was next to zero social class consciousness. This begs the question of how the Russian Empire became the USSR. Well, Vladimir Lenin saw the conditions of Russia as unable to fit the demands of original and orthodox Marxism, and he pretty much started improvising. He basically said that he would run a party with educated people on Marx, and they would carry out the revolution, and not actually the workers themselves. Once the party is successful, they would rapidly industrialize the economy with centralized planning and educate the masses about Marxism. As we saw in the Great October Socialist Revolution, they were successful. How long they were successful, I will not talk about in this video. The Khrushchevites, Gorbachev, and the revisionism is another and much bigger topic. I highly recommend you read State and Revolution, if you have not already, to hear what Lenin has to say more about the revolution, the dictatorship of the proletariat, and the role of the state in society to achieve socialism. Well, Sveta, how exactly does this relate to today's politics? Is Marxism-Leninism still relevant today? Well, I'm glad you asked, because, short answer, yes, it is still very relevant. The longer answer is that the vanguard and the dictatorship of the proletariat can be applied to current conditions of many capitalist nations around the world, especially overexploited ones. As Stalin stated in his book, The Foundations of Leninism, Leninism is a product of imperialism, which means that this vanguardist ideology comes to the people out of imperialistic nations such as Russia, France, England, and the United States of America. Meanwhile, Lenin's definition of imperialism still stands very true today, so, in effect, this means that Marxism-Leninism is not a null and void ideology, and its main reason to why it's so popular to this day. How exactly, however, can the ML ideology be used in nations such as the United States? Nowadays, we live in a service economies, with barely any industrialized workers, and next to no class consciousness. This is almost exactly like the conditions of 1917's Russia. Sure, Marxism-Leninism's main critique is that it's still valid, and that is authoritarian. But too many people are unaware of Marxist issues and need a vanguard to get them up on their feet for the proletariat revolution. If the vanguard isn't able to keep onto its control and stay true to the revolution, the people of nations would end up stagnating progress towards socialism, such as in the Khrushchevite USSR, or having it even bounce back, such as in the 1990s USSR or in the People's Socialist Republic of Albania. Well, thank you for watching to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. It's supposed to just be a simple explanation video, nothing too much right now. In the future, I will make more in-depth topics, so press subscribe, and hopefully I'll get around to making those. See ya!